So just about set now. And now the shortstop, Wander Franco.
Leading off the afternoon for Tampa Bay, the shortstop, Wander.
The wind of the Franco. Pitch. Swings and misses. And we're underway here this afternoon. The pitch. Check swing went around. And it's 0-2. And the pitch. Got him. One up, one down. Lau at the plate.
Static second. The second baseman, Brandon Lau.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing in one. That one missed. The pitch. And that one fouled off. The 1-2. And that misses off the outside edge. Right side. A little bloop single. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a lawn dart in there, and he found a way.
G-Man Choi in the box here lets that one go for a ball. At the belt and fires. And now 2-0.
Clearly didn't come out of his hand the right way. Left that curveball way up.
And now 2-1.
As a hitter, you got to learn something from that pitch. You clearly wasn't timed up on the fastball. In a 2-0 count, you have to be ready to do damage.
That one not close. 3-1 now. Next pitch has popped up. Drury makes the play. 2-0.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
The designated hitter, Randy Arozarena.
Randy Arozarena swings through one there.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
This one in the dirt, and the runner holds. Here's the 0-2. Ball one there.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Now a fly ball to right center. Grisham moving to his left. Makes the grab on the run. And that will end the inning. Bottom of the first. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Jurickson Profar.
For the Padres, the left fielder, Jurickson.
And he deals.
Profar.
A little bit low. Glass now. Ready and deals. Pitch misses. Now 2-0. Left hand batter waits. And a four pitch walk.
Now, this is a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
And now it's Juan Soto.
Soto.
Glass now back to work, the 0-1.
Well, Juan Soto had a huge 2021 season, just one point shy of 1,000 for OPS. Absolutely a monster at the plate. This guy's pretty special.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Peralta brings it in, and there's one away. Here's Manny Machado, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field.
Manny Machado.
Bum, 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 swings through that one. 0-1.
Well, the hitter looked pretty comfortable on that swing. Pitchers don't like to see that. See how he changes it up on this next pitch.
So now 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Man at first. And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. First offering misses the mark. Missed inside with the curve.
2-0 count to a guy with this much pop at the dish. Better expect him to be turning on something. It's going to either get hit hard to the pull side or the fans better look out in the stands.
Next pitch in for a strike, 3-1.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
Fouls one away and now 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
Here comes a 3-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. All set for the start of the inning. And the batter now, Yandy Diaz.
Leading off for the Rays, the third baseman, number 2. Yandy Diaz.
A wind of the pitch. Late on that fastball. Swing and a miss.
I'll tell you what, he's embarrassed right now. Never swings at that kind of pitch, especially that early in the count.
Next offering misses. 1-2 to count. And here it comes. They say it went. Sends it to first. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Just not a good pitch to swing at. One reason he's an everyday player is he usually lays off of that jump.
Manuel Margot.
Manuel Margot up to the plate. Up the middle, and it finds its way through for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away. So Margot is aboard.
Oh, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Really nice job staying up the middle. With his approach, he didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
David Peralta at the plate. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Here's the pitch. Runner on the goal. There's the ball. Throw, and they got him. Next offering is foul back. And a ball and two strikes. And that skips in the dirt. No score here in the second. Comebacker to the mound. And it gets by him. But in time, nice job to stay with it to end the inning. We head to the bottom of the second. Here's the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
For the Padres, the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
The pitch. Just missed.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Next pitch is inside, and now 2-0. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
And there's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Brandon Drury to the plate. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Second inning here, no score. Next offering is in for a strike.
That's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation.
Cronenworth runs. Zunino throw. Got him. That one drifts inside. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. That one's in there, 0-1. And the pitch. He swings and fouls one off. Drury, the base runner at first with one out. Next pitch is downstairs. Peralta right there to make the grab. Out number two. Jorge Alfaro at the plate. It's interesting he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. In the air, right field. Margot makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, here's Kiermaier now.
Leading off for Tampa Bay.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position, because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
On the ground, right side. And that one finds its way through. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Batting nine.
Mike Zunino getting ready to hit. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. Kiermaier on the go. Swing and a miss. The tag, and he's out at second. Kicks and fires. Check swing, but he went too far. That is strike two. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Started to swing, held up. Top of the third, no score. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Wander Franco. The switch hitter batting right. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Two outs. Bounced out to short. Kim over to pick it up. Gathers and throws to first. Franco gone on the play. Third out. Back here in San Diego, set for the bottom of the third. Stepping in for San Diego, Ha-Sung Kim. Here comes a pitch. That misses. Ball one. And a pitch. He was late there, strike one.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch, can't catch up.
And now it's even up. Next offering is foul back. 2-2 now. Got him. Another strikeout for Glasnow. Now batting Jurickson Profar.
Number 10, Jurickson Profar.
In there for strike one. Profar gets a piece there. Next pitch is outside.
Too close for me, partner, to take that 0-2 fastball, but for whatever reasons, he let it go by. He's still in the at-bat. I don't think he'll let the next one go.
Kiermaier pulls it down, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Juan Soto.
The right fielder, Juan Soto.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And there's a ball.
Rarely will you see a pitcher just waste a pitch like that. The batter wasn't even tempted to swing. Every pitch needs to have a purpose so that it can set up a following pitch to help you get that out.
In the air, out towards left center. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. And it gets by him. Around second now as they still don't have it.
Really nice job, a two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Didn't try to do too much with it, just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days now with guys trying to launch and hit home runs, but sometimes you got to shorten up just like that.
Machado stands in now, looks at that one inside. There's a swing and a drive. Way back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. Manny Machado leaves the yard, and they grab the lead. It's 2-0.
With this guy's velocity, a changeup is really a break for a hitter. He got a BP fastball, didn't move a whole lot, and he absolutely tattooed it.
Base is empty with two away. Here's Josh Bell. Up first offering, and it just misses.
The first baseman. Josh.
Two down, nobody on.
Bell.
Inside just missed. And the righty deals. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
They just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
Singy, I think just our presence is the present. Cronenworth in the box now. No balls and a strike.
There it was, a high-velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good...
And there's the third out. That'll do it for the inning. Welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. And stepping in for the Rays, Brandon Lau.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Next pitch misses, and the count is 1-1. And now the lefty fouled off. He was late.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
And a foul ball. He stays alive. And down on strikes. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth. And now the hitter, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi.
Line drive, and there's a hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
First pitch swing in, went up there with a plan to be aggressive. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Check swing on the first pitch. Appeal down to first. And Jerry Hillsdale says he went around. Liner, base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Back-to-back base hits. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones. where you got to make them pay.
Yandy Diaz now. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Next offering is in for a strike. There's the swing and a miss. Choi over at second. A Rosarena over at first with one away. And now the count is even.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste six or seven pitches on one hitter.
Two down. So first and second with two outs. Here's Manuel Margot. Slice down the right side. Oh, and two as he waves at that one. First and second, two down. The next offering misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And that'll do it. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Down to third baseman, Brandon Drury.
The third baseman.
Yeah, the right hander back to work. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there.
That big curve inside's a pitch that can buckle you a little bit. Looks like a fastball out of the hand and then just drops over that inside part of the plate.
Next one misses. Going to count 1-2.
Looks like he was trying to get to the front door with that curveball. It's definitely a finesse pitch.
Swing, and this one's blasted. It's got a chance. High bounce takes it over the fence for an automatic double.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Grisham batting for the second time, and that's strike one. Deal one. Zach Bunt towards third. And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And the Padres waste the chance.
Now batting. Catcher.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Jorge Alfaro. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Runner at second here, one gone. And now the count 1-2 after the swing and the miss. The next pitch misses, now 2-2. Runner leads away at second. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Gets the out, two down after the strikeout. Ha-Sung Kim digs in now. Went down on strikes his first time through.
Shortstop.
Next pitch downstairs. Ball one. And that one almost got him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
2-0. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Drury rounds third, headed for the plate. And it gets by him. Runner from second crosses the plate. It's 3-0.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. They call those the alleys for a reason, man. They're long, and if you can't cut the ball off as an outfielder before it gets by you, that hitter's going to run for a while. That right there is a beautiful swing and nice hustle for the triple.
That's out to center field. makes the grab on the run. And that is that. And welcome back. Stepping in, David Peralta. The Rays in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at-bat out of him right here.
First offering misses the mark.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Next pitch is outside. And he deals. That one fouled off, 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Here's now Kevin Kiermaier.
Pretty amazing going way back. Possibly the best center fielder I've ever seen.
Swings through that one. 0-1. The pitch. Check swing, but he went too far. No balls, two strikes. And ball one. Left-hand hitter waits. Right side. And the first two set down in the top of the fifth.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
Here's Mike Zunino.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Next offering misses, and that's ball one. The wind of the pitch. Dives, and he can't hang on. Not in time. Great effort, but it's an infield hit.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. It sounded different than most hits coming off the bat. You don't need numbers to tell you the ball was hit extremely hard, but at 115 miles per hour, that's not an exit velocity you see very often.
Well, got to pause on that thought, as that'll do it for the inning. Back here at Petco Park, we head to the bottom of the fifth, and now the right fielder, Juan.
The right fielder, Juan Soto.
Braley back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Swing and a pop-up. He makes the grab, and there's one down. And now it's Manny Machado.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Manny Machado.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Got one already tonight. I wouldn't be surprised if he pops another one here.
At the belt and fires. Check swing went around. 0-2. One down, base is empty. And that one sliced foul. The pitch. Bounce to the right. Choi collects. Off-balance throw in time. Home half of the fifth inning, moving along, two quick outs.
Now back.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Josh Bell stands in with two away as he takes a ball. The lefty, the 1-0. And he pumps it a strike. Here's a 1-1. And another ball.
I got 2-1 to count.
Pitch misses there. And that's ball three. And he walked him.
Well, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
Jake Cronenworth, the next up for the Padres. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Next offering is foul back. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. That's out number three. Out of the bullpen for the Padres, number 21. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings. And you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
The wind of the pitch. Lau at the plate for the third time as he comes up empty there. A one down. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
I'll tell you this, that's going to go on that pitcher's highlight reel.
Lau checks his swing. Appeal down to third. He did not go around. 1-2 now. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Oh, next for Tampa Bay.
Now up for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi, 1-for-2. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. Check swing. Went around. 0-2 now. Righty delivers. Stays alive. The 0-2. And that just misses. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Righty to the plate. And a ball evens the count. And fouled off. Next pitch inside, and the count's full.
Still just the second batter of the inning, and on the mound, he's already thrown 13 pitches. They got him working hard out there.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the wall. Very gritty. Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Man at first, Yandy Diaz. Next to hit for the Rays.
Yandy Diaz.
Oh, and he hit him.
That's one of those lookout pitches. As soon as it leaves the pitcher's hand, you start bracing for impact, knowing that it's going to be hard to get out of the way of that one.
Manuel Margot, the next to hit. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. And the right-hander deals. In the dirt. Nothing happening on the bases, though. Right-handed reliever. And look out. That one gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
Well, he's kind of backed himself into a corner, and I'm sure starting to feel the pressure right now. We'll see if he can bear down and get out of this one.
David Peralta stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. There's a strike. Choi on third. Diaz on second. Margot at first. Two out of the inning. Next offering is foul back. Next one misses. 2-2. Ground ball to the right side. Base hit. One run is in. Ball comes in. Runner stops at third. Base is still loaded with two out.
Just a huge at bat right there. Just one of those seen eye base hits.
Tim Hill into the game. This won't be easy for him as he comes in with the bases loaded. Now here is Kevin Kiermaier. Swings through that one. 0-1. So the tying run at second. Bases loaded. Two down. Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2. Oh, and now a wild pitch. Count moves to 2-2 as the runners hold. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Profar makes the play, and that will end the inning. Back here at the ballpark, well, we go bottom six, and now Brandon Drury.
The third baseman, Brandon Drury.
And a pitch. Whips it across, and a quick out number one. And the batter now, Trent Grisham. We talk about guys with good speed.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there's certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Next offering is in for a strike. And here it comes. And a count 1-2. The 1-2. This one high in the air to left center. Peralta on the move as he glides back and puts the squeeze on that one. Two down. And here's the catcher, Jorge Alfaro.
The catcher, Jorge Alfaro.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. There's a strike. The pitch. Line drive caught. Back here in San Diego, we go to the top of the seventh. And now the catcher for the Rays, Mike Zunino.
The catcher, Mike.
Here comes a pitch. And misses inside. And a pitch. And a foul ball. Kicks and deals. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
Hard ground ball, base knock. And it gets by him. Now he'll turn for second. And he'll pull into second safely.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. A well-deserved double on a...
Now batting Wander Franco on the ground right side. Over to first. That's the first out at the top of the seventh. And now it's Brandon Lau.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Don't be surprised to ball on the ground to the corners if they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base.
Calls it in, and there's two away. G-Man Choi now at the plate.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And first offering is fouled off.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
Out to short. Kim picks it up in plenty of time to first. Out number three.
For the traditional seventh hitting stretch.
Welcome back. Bottom of the seventh. Now it's the shortstop, Ha-Sung Kim.
Leading off for the Padres, the shortstop, Ha-Sung Kim.
Hawaii to kick the pitch. Missing inside, 1-0.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Fly ball down the line. Full extension makes the catch.
Just a great jump off the bat, and he was fully committed. Lays out, dives, makes a beautiful catch, and his pitcher is going to be pretty happy about that one.
So the San Diego batting order turns over. Jurickson Profar, the next up for the Padres. And the first offering is not close. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. That one felt good, and they add to the lead. It's 4-1. Base is empty, one away. Now the youngster Juan Soto.
Now batting the right fielder.
And first offering is fouled off.
Soto.
A wind in the pitch. And that one is lifted in the air. He's got it, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Now next to hit, Manny Machado. Good contact guy, good defender.
Machado.
First pitch, not close. Two outs. That clips the inside corner for a strike.
Well, I've noticed they've been pitching him hard inside, and the key is if you're going to make a mistake, you got to make it off the...
Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. And that one is going to go. A shot to left. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 5-1. Josh Bell will hit next. He's 0-1.
Bell, your attention, please. Now pitching for the Rays. Number 60, Jared Levin.
And that's in there for strike one. Right through there for a strike.
Quickly in an 0-2 hole, you're going to have to give something up here in terms of power if you want to put the ball in play with any authority.
Hard on the ground to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. We go to the eighth. Now it's Randy Arozarena.
Leading off for Tampa Bay. The designated hitter, Randy Arozarena.
And the pitch. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one. And he hits a ground ball right side. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground. Nice ground out.
Yandy. Here's the third. So Craig Stammen into the game. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Number 34, Craig Stammen.
Ground ball up the middle. Kim picks it up. Tosses to first. And a couple of quick outs. Now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot.
Right fielder, Manuel Margot.
On the ground. Cronenworth collects it. To first. Rays retired in order. And welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. So digging in now for San Diego. Jake Cronenworth.
The second baseman. Jake Cronenworth. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please.
The pitch.
Now pitching for Tampa Bay.
That one missed.
Number 29, Peter
Fairbanks. Kicks and fires. And there's a foul ball. Next offering is in the dirt. Cronenworth checks his swing, appeal to third, and he held up. Up the middle, Franco handles, and he's safe at first.
Now back.
So, man aboard. Down the third baseman, Brandon Drury. First offering misses badly for ball one. The pitch. And there's a ball.
2-0 count, great hitter at the dish. If you're going to miss, you've got to miss outside the zone. You miss inside the strike zone, you'll be asking the umpire for a new baseball.
Nobody out, runner at first. Swings and misses. One gone here. Trent Grisham, the next up for the Padres. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful.
He's so solid, calms the heart rate of the pitcher and the manager when the ball goes up in the air. You just automatically assume that it's an out every time it's hit in the air.
Cronenworth over at first with one away. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's his second strikeout. Jorge Alfaro, the next up for the Padres.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial gold glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
In the air, center field. Makes a nice running catch. And that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, all set to start the ninth in this one. And now it's going to be David Peralta.
David.
The pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now one away. Man at first, Mike Zunino. Next to hit for the Rays. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Well, strike one is so critical that in a bat like this with a real threat at the plate looking to do damage.
And now just two outs away. And the righty deals. That catches the corner.
Well, he went inside a couple of times and now outside. Hitter's not exactly sure where to look for this next pitch.
Righty to the plate. Ground ball left side, could be two. Tosses to first. Now only one out remaining. So the batting order turns over at the plate. Wander Franco. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Well, I say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. There's a little bit more confidence to move through the at bat.
Man on second, two down. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Whether you're a season ticket holder or you just come to a couple of games a year, to see your team win at home, there's just something special about that. Good job by these guys to get it done for the hometown fans.
5-1 is how it ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Score for this afternoon's ballgame for the victorious San Diego Padres. 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Rays, 1 run on 9 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. Time of the ballgame, 2 hours and 52 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.